Hello folks, welcome to today's video. So today we are going to continue with the series of what went wrong in that particular interview. And yes, today we will talk about Honeywell UOP and my interview experience in Honeywell UOP. I've already shared that interview experience, that what are the rounds that are there in Honeywell UOP selection, what is the exact procedure for the same, what are the questions that you can expect in PI, or what are the topics in the GD or the type of questions in the aptitude. I've made a separate video on that. You can refer to that. I will be providing the link in the description box. So if you haven't seen that particular Honeywell UOP selection procedure or the interview procedure for Honeywell UOP yet, then straight away go to that link and refer to that link and see the video first if you want to find out the procedure. Today I'm going to talk about why I got rejected in the final PI. In fact, fun fact is I was given an opportunity to appear for the PI twice and for two different profiles that Honeywell gave a chance. I was the only candidate that was given a chance to contest for two different profiles and I got selected in neither of them. And today I'm going to reveal why is it so. After self-introspection, I came out with this conclusions, and hence I would suggest you not to do these things, particularly when you are appearing for a PI. So let me tell you, the procedure of Honeywell UOP itself included two profiles, out of which one was field operative services, FOS, where you need to implement the design that you have already made theoretically on field and you need to set up a plant. So it's basically commissioning of a plant, implementing the design on paper practically on field, so, and also managing equipments on field, trying to track down their problems and trying to solve it with your theoretical domain knowledge. Another was basically design profile, so you need to design the equipments, you need to jot down the PFD, PNID, what are the instruments required, what will be the pipeline sizes, where do you need controllers, how many do you need, design of specific equipments like distillation columns, absorption towers, everything about it, the saddles, the mechanical design, the process design, how many saddles are going to be there, what type of distribution system you are going to use. I'm not going to go into the specifics of this, but these are the contents of the design profile. And as I've already told, that FOS profile consisted mostly about the implementation of the design on the field, as the name suggests, field operative services. So I definitely chose for the FOS profile because I'm always intrigued by the field study or implementing theoretical knowledge domain into the field. So I thought that the process and the profile particularly suited me, and that's why I straight away I applied for the FOS profile. And the number of seats for the FOS profile, unfortunately didn't know it back then, was less as compared to the design profile, and the competition was decently almost equal in both the profiles. So obviously the competence, since the number of competents are same and that seats are less, so more competition is going to be there in the FOS profile. Now what happened is, I was going in for the interview, and as I went in for the interview, I'm going to straight away come to the interview experience and what went wrong. I was asked about NPSH and cavitation. I explained NPSH and cavitation. I've made a separate video on NPSH and cavitation earlier as well, how to answer those particular questions. I answered it similarly and they were quite impressed with the answer, and then they continued counter questioning the same, and I answered all the counter questions. Then I was asked about the FCC unit, that is fluidized catalytic cracking. I've also made a video on that as well specifically, and I explained them the entire design and the working principle of a particular FCC unit, more in terms of theoretical knowledge domain rather than practical application. I told them the applications definitely, but when and how it is installed, that I didn't tell them. So somehow after the interview was half or 75%, I would say, done, they suggested me to go for the design profile. Because they thought that my theoretical knowledge or the expression of the same was a bit more inclined towards design rather than FOS, or I will be, they told me this term in particular when I was opting for FOS profile, and I was in the interview of FOS profile, the panelists insisted me to go for the design profile by telling me that I think you are way too technically strong and I think the company will benefit more if we put you in the design profile. So I told them that personally I don't have any problem in adjusting to the situation. I am comfortable working anywhere you place me, but I would like to go for the FOS profile because I think my profile or my personal choice would be to go for the FOS or the field operative services profile in particular. But they kept on insisting me to agree upon the design profile, and they would refer me to the panelist of the design profile, and then I would have a separate interview for the design profile job. So my only fault in this interview was that I was sounding too much technical about what I said. I went into the descriptive details, so I would ask you to refrain from doing so. Do not go into the intricate details if it is not for the design profile, or if it is not a core technical company. If they're hiring more of communicative people, or more of shift in charges, or rather more of process driven people, rather than going into the core technical design details, you can focus on the overview, and you can focus more on the process lines rather than going into the intricate design details of a particular equipment. That I would suggest you to do. Depending on the profile that the core company is hiring, you should manage your answers accordingly. And that is the mistake that I did. I should have searched a little more about the FOS profile and the requirements for the same, so that I could have framed my answers such that they wouldn't have felt that I am way too technically sound, or I am trying to go into the design intricate details. But because somewhere down the line they felt that I am perfect for the design profile, but I'm not very suitable for the FOS profile, that's why they referred me to the design sector. Another mistake of this interview was I agreed to what they insisted on. Sometimes the interviewers will test your patience. They will try to deceive you on the other path by misguiding you or misleading you, or trying to deceive you by giving lucrative offers in other fields. And if you are deviated or if you're convinced by them, they will definitely, that will not be a good impression upon the panelists. You should stick to your words. You should stick to your verdict right from the beginning, and you should emphasize on that till the very end. So you should stick to what you say right from the beginning. My other mistake was I agreed to go for the design profile once they insisted me to do so, because that was also right at the beginning of my interview season, and I didn't want to lose an offer. And since they were insisting me that I would be good for the design profile, I went for it. Now, for the design profile, as I went in, the panelists there straight away told me that your interview is going to be the last, because the ones that have already opted primarily for the design profile, we are going to take their interview, and once we finalize the candidates out of them, and then we are going to take your interview, since you have been referred to by the FOS profile panelist and you have not chosen design as your primary choice. So that was clearly a disadvantage, and I always knew that once they take the interview of all the candidates and they have selected the names, it's going to be difficult for me to convert, because I've been referred and I have not made my primary choice as design. So the design panelists were first of all not very satisfied with this kind of an approach. Since my secondary choice was design, so definitely I would be given less preference than the ones who have selected design as their first choice. And that happened. The design profile candidates were taken, given the chance to give the interview, and the interviews of some of them went very smooth, and they were selected. They were sent to the HR people also, and around 7:30 or 8, just as an obligation, they called me for the interview. Already the ones that were selected of the FOS of that or of the design profile were sent for the HR final HR round, and as they were having the HR round, I was called as an obligation to the design department. I always knew that I lacked the chances there, as it was way too late, and I was pretty sure that they have selected the candidates already. So I got a little punched up in between the design and the FOS profile due to my own deeds and my not so favoring luck. And as I went for that design profile interview, the first question that came up, that why didn't you give design as the first preference? And I always knew this question was going to come, but I took a stand this time. I told them that I am much interested in the FOS profile, and whenever I think that I can implement the designs on field, I have butterflies in my stomach. And the interviewers was straight away on the point that butterflies in your stomach when you think of the FOS profile is not very good in the interview of the design profile. So that was one more mistake. Since I am appearing for the design profile, I should have been a little more diplomatic at that point of time. Shouldn't have stuck to my initial verdict of staying good with the FOS profile. I should have told them that I chose FOS profile, but they felt that I'm technically a little more sound, and that's why I've been referred to in the design design profile, and I would be comfortable working here as well. Since I told them that I have a primary interest in FOS profile, they were convinced that I was not the right candidate right from the very beginning. So do not commit this mistake. Do not appreciate the other profile or the other company when you're sitting for a particular profile or a particular company, because that gives a negative impression about you sitting for that particular company or particular profile. And then came the question about my favorite subject. What is your favorite subject? And the interview was interrupted once or twice because T appeared right in the beginning, and one of the interviewers went out for tea and dinner. And as the interview was going in, another interviewer received a call and he walked out. So one by one, both the interviewers walked out of the interview midway, and that was interrupted. Once again, a bad luck. And questions that were asked to me in the design profile was my favorite subject. And as I told them that it is Chemtech, one of the panelists had a huge experience in chemical technology in particular. And he straight away questioned me about the carbon numbers. What are the carbon numbers that are there, and how do you segregate them in terms of fuels? So I've made a separate video on that as well, the carbon numbers and the consecutive petroleum cuts. What is gasoline, C5, C6 primarily? What is LPG, C3? What is methane, C1? What is ethylene, C2 in primary? And what is diesel, C23? What is kero cut and ATF cut, C13 to C18? What is lubricating oil cut to C26? Insulating oil, C29? Like this, he told me to segregate the cuts, and I told him that these are the cuts and these are the carbon numbers. And then it straight away went to the boiling point of it, that tell me the boiling point. Now, boiling point is something that is very rigorous to remember, and that's why I do not generally prefer remembering numbers or mugging up numbers in particular, because I think that I'm not appearing for UPSC examinations, I'm appearing for a technical examination where I'm supposed to know the logic behind the happenings and the technical domain for the same. I shouldn't remember numbers, because numbers are available there in the network whenever you search on the internet, or available in the books as well. If I remember the boiling points, then what is the motive behind it? I do not see any particular motive or any particular advantage when I remember the boiling points in particular. Rather, I would learn a new logic or a new technical thing or two about carbon numbers, rather than remembering the boiling points. So till date, I do not consider that as my fault that I didn't know the boiling point. And he was disappointed that I didn't know the boiling point. Then he told me what are the uses of C7 to C10 cut. I explained him that it is basically used in catalytic reforming chambers to blend with gasoline. It is used as a precursor to ATF or kerosene to lighten the product. It is used in the petrochemical industry as well. And then he asked me about C13 to C18 cut. Apart from kerosene and ATF, what do you think it is used for? I told him it can be used as a precursor of diesel to lighten the diesel, and so that it easily vaporizes at occasions. And I forgot at that point of time, he asked me about labs. Do you know something about labs? So I completely forgot that C13 cut out of the NC12 cut, sodium dodecyl benzene sulfonate is formed, which is a detergent, and that is sodium dodecyl benzene sulfonate is called a linear alkyl benzene lab. At that point of time, he told me what is lab, and since he asked me the use of the C12 or the C13 cut, he specifically asked me that what is lab, do you particularly remember lab? I didn't remember lab, that was my fault once again, and that's why I was bogged down. And he also asked me about pump selection, the characteristic curve and the operating curve. I told him that as well. But since the damage was half done, it was a final nail in the coffin that I couldn't answer the boiling points and the labs concept, the C13 or C12 cut explanation of the manufacturing of detergents. Unfortunately, I was not selected, and these were the primary reasons. I think if I stuck to my answer of going for the FOS profile, I could have been selected there. But unfortunately, I opted to switch to the design profile instead of not wanting to do so, but not letting go of the opportunity as well, trying to play on the dual boat. That has been my case throughout my life, and dwelling on the dual boat eventually led to sanking of the boat, and also I didn't get Honeywell UOP. But what happened. I wanted to learn from my mistakes, and I do not want to repeat the same. So I think that will be helpful, and that will be all for today. If you liked it, like it, share it with your friends, subscribe to our channel. We will keep on bringing more videos like this. Thank you very much.